Time for my comeuppance! This is the top 10 WWE wrestlers that I like that everyone else hates. Not really hates, just doesn't like. Again, this is just my opinion. I'm wrong. Don't pay attention to me. Don't take this seriously. It's just an opinion thing, and it's not even 100% that I love them and everyone doesn't. It's the ratio of me liking and they don't. Kind of how it balances out determines where they are on this list. So, without further delay, let's get started. Number 10 is actually a group, and it's a group that people in audiences are pretty well behind, but the internet community is getting kind of sick of them. Can you guess who it is? Don't you dare be sour.
You don't... Oh, right, yeah.
The New Day!
You're like, you don't like The New Day? And then I realize this is the ones you like.
Yeah.
I'm
a big fan of The New Day. But a lot of the people on the internet are getting a little tired of them. You know, that's what happens when you have a long-ass title reign, is, you know, they started as heels, as champions, and then became babyfaces and now lost their titles as soon as they broke Demolition's record. And, you know, it became obvious as soon as they started to be like, oh my god, they've been champions for a long time, that's what they were going for, especially with the lawsuit and whatnot. The New Day is getting turned on a bit from the internet community because they were around for a long time. They started to get annoying, apparently. I don't know. I liked them. I still do. I think that eventually, you know, Kofi's going to be the first one to leave WWE. And I think Big E is going to be the big breakout star. And I would like to see Xavier Woods officially convert to Austin Creed so he could just literally be the guy from Up, Up, Down, Down. Just be that guy. And then fucking fight Zack Ryder for the internet title or some stupid shit like that. But honestly, still love The New Day. I think they're great. I think they need to stick around for a while. I'd love to see them become three-time tag team champions. But yeah, I love The New Day. I don't know why people are getting sick of them, but that is what it is. All right, with number 9, I got to explain it before I even say who the fuck I'm talking about. Number 9 is not someone that I'm really all that excited about. He's not someone that I'm a huge fan of, but he is someone that I don't think deserves all the hate that comes his way. I'm talking about Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns, motherfucker, the guy! I don't like the guy, I didn't like Suffering Succotash, and I don't like his face. Thing is that I know he can do better. His matches with AJ Styles were phenomenal. He's been getting a lot better ever since the peak of the hate Roman Reigns trend. And, you know, he's been getting a lot better in the ring. On the microphone, he's still a bit wooden, but he's been getting a little bit better. He could use a lot of work, but that's the problem with the current WWE model, is people are getting rushed to the main roster and rushed to the top of the ladder. And, you know, that's a problem, but he's gonna get better. I don't think he's world championship material. I don't think he deserves to be at the top quite yet. But I think where he is now with the US title, I think that's a pretty good place for him, even though he does carry the fucking title like a sack of potatoes. He's a fucking
sack of potatoes?
A sack of potatoes? He needs to wear that title with pride, goddammit. He's the US champ!
And wash his hair!
Yes, fucking Jesus. Shampoo and conditioner. Like I said, it's not necessarily because I'm a huge Roman Reigns fan. His booking does kind of piss me off a little bit, but then I realized, you know, this guy's a millionaire, and he doesn't give a fuck about that. And
I wouldn't either.
So he's kind of already turned heel in my mind, but that and in the fact that I know he's not the person who's deciding the way his matches go. I don't like I don't like how he's been booked, but looking at him as a character, I think it's kind of fascinating to see someone who, with one move, can put almost anyone down. I think that's fucking cool. With one spear, he can fucking demolish Rusev. With one spear, he can take down AJ Styles. With one spear, he can do damage to fucking anybody. And I think that is pretty fucking intriguing. So if they turned him heel and made him this monster who really just fucking cherish the spear, make it the fucking thing, make him go against Goldberg, spear versus spear match, then you can make him fucking show him how it's done, Goldberg, because he, shit, isn't that kind of a fucking situation, isn't that kind of bad when I'm asking Goldberg to teach someone how to wrestle? Number 8 is Luke Harper. Not a lot of people give a fuck about Luke Harper, but he is part of a heel faction, and people don't really give him enough credit. He is extremely underrated, he's a very athletic character, and I even like that little fucking arrow thing he's been doing with the clothesline. I think that's pretty cool. He's pretty good on the mic. If he give him some space, maybe trim him down to when he looked like Negan. Like, he used to legitimately look like Negan! And, you know, if you just let him cut loose a little bit, I hate to say get him away from the Wyatt family. Maybe make him transform into that character before you take him away from the Wyatts, and then have this big Bray versus Harper thing. You know, Harper starting to realize that he can do it on his own and blah, blah, blah. You know, down the line. But point is, Luke Harper is actually pretty damn good, and I think if you give him credit and actually look at him, you know, he tends to fade into the background, especially now that Bray is taking a backseat to Randy Orton in the Wyatt family, which is fucking dumb. But,
Bray is horrible luck as, like, a cult leader.
Yeah. And he's... Bray is... I love Bray, but...
I don't think WWE understands what a cult is.
Yeah, they need to fucking...
It's not a club where members just go and, you know, yeah. That shit fucks up your head.
They need to fix the Wyatt family, and I think if they make Luke Harper into this Negan-esque character, especially with The Walking Dead being so popular, it would be blatant, but it'd be a natural fit for Luke Harper. Just make him, like, the top general of the Wyatt family, and then have a power struggle, and I think it'd be cool. You'd have to add a lot of members to it, which would be good, because it's the Wyatt family, it's a cult. They should be adding people. It should be a virus into the fucking... Anyway, Luke Harper, he's good. Moving on. Number 7 is Mark Henry. I love Mark Henry. I think he's a great talker on the microphone. His fake retirement speech, holy fuck, I cried. It was emotional. His fake retirement speech. It really struck, it really worked. It was the best thing to come out of his John Cena feud. And I like his matches. Nowadays, he's a bit slower than before, but he's still genuinely impressive, and I think he deserves to be more than just, oh yeah, Mark Henry. I think he deserves to have one last little bit of a, oh yeah, he's super fucking strong. Maybe build him in the Wyatt family, and he becomes the muscle that eventually becomes too old to do it or some shit. I don't know. Ever since he and Big Show started growing beards, I'm like, oh, maybe they're gonna be the Wyatt muscle, and that would be fucking cool. Give a new lease to these older guys. Give them a new lease on life. That'd be nice, but whatever. I'm not booking this shit. I just... Fuck! But, yeah. So, Mark Henry, love him. Watch him on Table for Three. Oh man, that guy's a charming motherfucker.
See, I loved him on Table of Three as like a wrestler. Not a big fan of Mark Henry.
Okay.
I don't fucking hate him. I'm just like, meh.
Yeah. Number 6 is The Miz. The Miz! The Miz! The goddamn Miz. You know what? I used to fucking hate this guy. He has the most punchable fucking face in the WWE, but you know what?
He's wrestling Tom Cruise.
Yeah. You know, that fucking it. His most recent heel work, you know, the Talking Smack promo and everything he's doing, he's obviously goading on the GOAT, Daniel Bryan. He's trying his damnedest to be hated, and he's doing a great job. He's being a terrific heel. He's being really good at his job, so much so that people are loving someone they're supposed to hate. And I think that's pretty cool. He's really coming to his stride and doing what he's doing, but what a lot of people forget to do is to realize that that's what he's been doing the whole fucking time. He has been this good for a long time. He's been doing pretty much the same shtick forever. He just didn't have, like, Maurice, and he didn't have a sort of beard. When he got help from The Rock to win at WrestleMania, people, you know, I didn't like it because The Rock had to fucking get himself involved, but the way that The Miz taunted after that, it was like, this is the same shit that he's doing now. The Miz has been really good for a long time, and what I didn't realize, you know, I only realized it until after that Talking Smack promo, is that that's him! He is just that good! Some of his best acting work has never been in any movie. It's been just this. So he's always been a great heel. Moving on, it's The Miz.
The Miz is kind of like how Chris Jericho used to be.
Yeah. Number 5 is Kane, the Big Red Machine Kane. Look, okay, so when Pete...
It's gotta be Kane!
It's gotta be Kane! Back in the day, Kane was amazing, and then people got sick of him. I I never really did. Okay, when he was coming out every fucking match, almost, in 2015 with the Authority, it's getting a little old, but then that gave us comedic Authority Kane, which I fucking loved. He was so funny, holy shit. When, you know, when the Demon Kane thing started, I don't like the name Demon Kane, but it fucking...
I'm sure he does it now.
The fucking...
Wait, I'm thinking of Sting.
Yeah. The fucking Authority Kane, he was boring and then he became funny. And I think that's what's supposed to happen. So, I love Kane. Again, he was always been great. He's had a lot of bad moments, but anyone who's around long enough will do that. I think he has transformed himself a lot. Yeah, I love Kane. Kane's cool. Number four, The Game, Triple H. Okay, before we started filming this, Brie mentioned that she can't stand Triple H anymore. Anymore.
Used to love him when I was a kid. Used to fucking
used to love him.
Worship him.
Yeah, like back in the day when he was the title-grabbing son of a bitch, like, he was the monster heel. The problem was that it got a little too much. But that's because in the Ruthless Aggression era, no one could get past the fucking upper echelon. And as soon as someone tried to, CM Punk, as soon as someone tried to, they tried to shut it down. But nowadays, if only Triple H, John Cena, and CM Punk were a few years younger, and they had come a little bit later, so that they could be around when Triple H took over. Okay, this doesn't make sense. But nowadays booking... If the Ruthless Aggression era was run by the Triple H of today, then it would have been a lot less exhausting. I honestly believe that. But Triple H then and now, especially now, his character should embrace the fact that he's in charge of fucking NXT, which would make him such a babyface, because everyone loves NXT. Oh my god. Yes, his hair was awesome, but the problem is it started to recede a bit, so... I liked it when he had the little fuzz up here. I think it evened out with his beard, I think it looked good, but the fucking head fold... That head fold is just too much. It's a little much. But if you gave him the mantle of the leader of the new era and really show who he is behind the scenes... Yo, make him... He is funny. He can be a funny guy. So if you make him the sort of babyface authority figure to counteract Stephanie McMahon on Raw, then you would have what they were trying to do with Shane and Stephanie before the brand split, but with someone that they've had a lot of time to get invested in. And then someone who can step in the ring. Triple H can still go. He is almost not slowed down at all. Like, he carried Sting through his match. Like, honestly, Sting, at this point, he's 50, he's mid-50s. He was relying on a lot of tricky spots. But Triple H made him look like $1 million. And Sting can still go, but he ain't what he used to be. Even when he was at his peak in WCW, him and Diamond Dallas Page were in their, like, late 30s, 40s.
Oh, yeah, and you could tell because Sting went from being, you know, just a fucking brute in the ring to being all about intimidation.
Yeah.
There was a lot of standing and staring and anticipation.
So, yeah, when it comes to Triple H, he can still go. He's still great. And if you let... And if he took his own fucking advice and let himself be himself... I think you could have, like, he could rival Vince McMahon in terms of the best authority figure to counteract Steph. You could literally turn Raw into some of the most interesting TV ever if you use those 3 goddamn hours to be Triple H's new era versus Stephanie McMahon's Ruthless Aggression, and you just have the fuckers battle. I think that would be amazing. And then Raw would fucking win against SmackDown easily. Because right now... Raw just seems like the same old shit. And then SmackDown Live has been the new era, and they're winning hands down. But if you put that competition on Raw, have Triple H at the helm of the babyface side, Stephanie McMahon on the other side, you have that sort of real-life drama, oh no, and then you can actually give them character, oh my god, it could be so good, but no. Vince has gotta die first. Oh, fuck, I shouldn't have said that.
Honestly, honestly, you already went over this, but I fucking love Triple H in real life. Because in real life, Triple H is fucking suburban dad.
Yeah.
That's who he's just like, laughing at his own jokes, just pleasant. Yeah. Kind of a jackass, but Triple H is my dad.
Triple H is your dad, he's my dad, he's everyone's dad. Triple H is the dad of the WWE.
And it's fucking great. Like, I love the guy. That's a huge reason why I worshipped him so much when I was a kid, is because, you know, he was a fucking asshole. He was a heel.
Yeah.
But he was so great. Just like The Rock. Charming as fuck.
Number 3. Braun Strowman. This is the problem with Braun Strowman.
For a second, I thought you were going to say Brock Lesnar.
No.
I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah. Braun Strowman, it's like with Roman Reigns. I'm not too terribly high up on Braun Strowman, but here's the thing about Braun Strowman, is that he's been given absolute shit, but he's gotten so much better than before. He used to like, now he's like, thump fucking fuck. Like, he's gotten so much, but that's walking across the ring, by the way, in case that didn't make any fucking sense. He's gotten so much better. He's gotten way less green. He's still got a lot of ways to go, but, you know, it's early in his career. Give him some fucking time. That's why he's not fighting for any championships right now. God damn it. That's why he's in the mid-card, motherfucker. Give him some time. Once he gets better, he's gonna be an amazing fucking main eventer. He's gonna be amazing. It's gonna be great. And, you know, he needs to lose the beard. Honestly, it makes his fucking mouth look like it comes out to here. He looks like he has a baby face. He changed his hair. He needs to change his beard. He needs to talk on his promos. Talk normally, for fuck's sake. His normal voice works great.
He's just like, he talks normally. It's like a pleasant British accent.
Hello, I am Braun.
Not intimidating at all.
I am Braun Strowman, and I am here to crush you. Oh, wait, is that Rusev's thing? Oh, shit. If you put Braun Strowman and let him really become something new, give him time to get better, he already has gotten a lot fucking better, then it would be a lot better. The problem is when people see big, huge guys destroying their favorites, they're like, Vince McMahon is trying to shove them down our throats. You realize where he is in the mid-card? He's fighting everyone to get a hand on Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn ain't a world champion. Sami Zayn ain't the main event. Sami Zayn ain't shit. And especially he should be going up against Sami Zayn, because Sami Zayn is an amazing wrestler, but he's making Sami Zayn someone who seems like he could fight anybody and barely win, maybe. Remember what I said in the last one. He's going up against Sami Zayn, so he's already still in the mid-card. And for a gigantic guy like Braun Strowman to be in the mid-card proves that Vince McMahon isn't the only person in charge anymore. Because if it was up to Vince, you know for fuck's sake that Braun would be fighting Roman Reigns for the Universal Championship every week. Like, it would just be those two all the fucking time. So, give him a chance. Hashtag give Braun a chance. And
go Braun Strudel.
Go Braun Strongman. Go, like, seriously. Let him change himself up a bit. Give him some time. He'll be fucking great. I'm a fan. Number 2 is probably going to cause a bit of a rift here. The number 2 WWE wrestler that I like, but a lot of people don't, including Brie, is Braun Apple Juice. It's John Cena. It's John Cena.
Do.
Oh, God. Okay. Again, I'm not huge fan of John Cena, but here's... I'm not a huge fan of John Cena, but I'll tell you this. John Cena, he's the best. He's magnificent. He's huge.
He could build the wall by himself.
Big muscles. He's huge. Bigly.
He's scary, though. It doesn't fit.
Yeah, he's too fucking big. John Cena in a suit is the most baffling fucking thing ever.
I know! Him in a shirt is the most baffling thing to me. I'm like,
It's fucking weird. But yeah, okay, so here's the thing about John Cena. He is currently doing the thing that he should be doing. And the thing that he should be doing is building up to being an asshole. This is what's going on. Like, everyone wanted him to do the heel turn before because they were like, they were just sick of him. But he didn't really have the motivation before. You know, people were like contriving ways he could have had the motivation, but now he has organic motivation. Every time he comes back, he keeps telling people, I'm sick of this new era bullshit. I'm here, I'm John Cena, and I'm the number one contender because I say so. I'm John Cena. And one, he should have to fight for that shit. He should come back, declare it, and then someone should be like, okay, but you have to fight for it. Like, that should be what should happen. It's not going to be what happens. Yeah, well, this is wrong show, man. This would be...
No, I want him to camp here.
Mick Foley comes out on SmackDown and is like, I don't know why I'm here. I thought I needed a new hip.
You talking shit?
Yeah. But,
Hell in the cell!
Yeah. But...
Yeah. He's just like a judge. I'm sorry.
John Cena, right now what he should be doing is getting more and more frustrated at the fact that the new era seems to be passing him by. Because he can still go. John Cena versus AJ Styles. AJ Styles can get a good match out of fucking anybody. But AJ Styles versus John Cena, some of the best work John Cena's ever fucking done. And so John Cena to come back and to constantly be reminded that AJ Styles is on top and that all these other people are coming in and is making him seem more and more irrelevant, what he should be doing is trying to come back, losing, coming back, losing, and then have to fight to stay alive. I would really love to see a John Cena that feels like he's drowning in relevance, in irrelevancy, because that is the true organic reason he would ever turn heel, is to try to stay alive, because he can still go. When fucking Hulk Hogan turned heel in WCW, he was wrestling, he was shit. He was absolute wrestling shit, but it worked for his character because he had support. Now, John Cena wouldn't need an outsiders, he wouldn't need a Nash and Hall. He wouldn't need NWO backup. He could be a one-man army trying to keep down the new era, which is what the fuck this, like...
Isn't John Cena, like, 32?
Something like that. He's
like, obscenely young him to be passed over already.
Yeah, like, the face of Ruthless Aggression, having to fight for relevancy in the new era, I think would be an interesting concept, and it would be a refreshing change from the old-time, out-of-date, out-of-touch authority figure fighting the new era. Instead, you'd have someone who thinks they're an authority figure fighting the new crop of talent, which means you would get a lot of great matches because the new era talent don't have the character work of the new era, but John Cena can still fucking go, and they're phenomenal wrestlers. So you get great matches. You can have John Cena help these guys with their character work, because this motherfucker, you can bounce off of John Cena. God damn it, the guy, like,
master of improv.
That guy does not get enough credit for his talking ability. And then, who the fuck knows, maybe he gets an injury, he could fucking take over for Daniel Bryan, which, holy shit, in and out of itself, John Cena trying to fight Daniel Bryan for a spot as GM so that he can have a reign of terror over SmackDown Live, god damn it, the possibilities are endless. All you have to do is have John Cena lose for a year. There you go, and then you can fucking make him have a heel turn, which would fucking revitalize everything. I know I'm sounding like the douchiest of marks right now, but he's never had the reason before. The streak was never that important to John Cena, otherwise he would have gone after it way long ago, so all that shit would have been, it wouldn't have felt real. Nothing would have felt real before. The closest thing would have been him fighting The Rock, but it didn't make sense for him to fight from below to turn bad. Now he's fighting from above, realizing that above isn't that high, now he's fighting for his life. That would be a great heel turn moment for him. But they're not gonna do any of that shit. As much as the shit that I just said makes me excited, makes me want to watch the fucking Royal Rumble and all of that shit, none of it's gonna fucking happen. So let's move on to number one. And number one, well, it's the Big Show! Okay, look, the Big Show came back here recently, and he was under 400 pounds. The dude is like 7 foot something, and he's maybe not over. I think he's 6'11", and he's under 400 pounds.
That's fucking ridiculous.
Yeah, it's amazing. He looks better than he almost ever has. And he, you know, he's a part-timer now. He's out of the main event picture, which is where he should be. Where he should be is out of the main event picture, I should mean. He's where he should be right now, is what I'm trying to say. He is a great character. If you let him be who he is, don't try to force him to do anything he doesn't want to do, and don't try to act and don't try to act like he's, you know, being forced into one direction or other. Like, if you have him do fucking heel work when he was a, when he is a face or anything like that, it gets old. But yeah, so Big Show, he gets the most shit because everyone's sick of this Big Show bullshit. But I love the Big Show. Don't give him the title again. Just let him be who he is for a while. Give him one last match against some young, strong person, and then send him off. Yeah, and get in John Cena, whatever. John Cena current retirement, WrestleMania 37. I don't give a shit. But anyway, so there you go. My number one wrestler that I like that everyone hates is the Big Show, Paul White. And that concludes my list for the top 10 WWE wrestlers that I like that everyone else hates. One last comment?
What it reminded me of when you were like, oh, just let the Big Show be himself, is when you're showing me that one clip where the guy fucking comes in all costumed out, and then when he gets into the ring after this dramatic entrance, he's like, look at this bullshit I'm wearing!
Oh yeah, Seven in Seven from WCW, Dustin Rhodes.
There you go.
But yeah, so anyway, thank you all very much for watching this list of my top 10 WWE wrestlers that I like that everyone else hates. Let me know who you like that everyone else hates in the comments below, and tell me how I'm wrong on all my social medias. You can find the links in the descriptions, blah blah blah. Anyway, I've been the Trained Unprofessional, speaking for the voices in my head when I say until next time. Fairly well, everyone. Bye, everybody! Bye, 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 bye. Yes, yes, Lucha, Lucha. Chalu.